Super Rugby, 90 seconds, let's go.
Scouring through the Super Rugby teams this week, one name struck me, Jan Serfontein. I have to admit I was deeply convicted by this because I was simply forgotten about this kid. He starts against the Sunwolves this weekend, and anyone that knows this game can't really tell you whether he'll be spectacular or absolute rubbish. This is really telling, and I don't know how a former Junior World Rugby Player of the Year gets to a point in his career where nobody is surprised by mediocrity, and in the same breath, nobody would be surprised if there was a dominant showing. This, remember, was the world's best under 20 player 5 years ago. 5 years ago. Let that sink in. There are a number of factors for his stagnation, and I don't think temperament is one of them, because he was very, very good when he broke onto the test scene a couple of years ago. Coaching shortcomings are definitely a factor. Frans Lurica and Nolis Maree are hardly men you want to entrust the best young players in the world to. A lack of high-quality, senior players from whom he can learn is another factor. But he can't be stripped of responsibility. He has to do whatever it takes to maximize his potential. Instead, his career trajectory has flatlined. And we're at the point now where we're in danger of seeing a player who should be a national treasure dying a very slow and public death. That Serfontein is not a national talking point for good reasons, week in and week out, is really distressing for me and should be for you too. We've become desensitized to stories like Serfontein's, and that's a very dangerous place to be. The apathy around this is really dangerous. Stories like Serfontein's are far too common when they really should have no place in South African rugby.